Continuing their journey by gypsy caravan along the old Pilgrim's Way between Winchester and Canterbury, this week playwright Peter Terson and travelling companion Dennis Skillicorn are moving on from Outwood to the village of Horn, and then crossing from Surrey into Kent and finishing up at Cheveney. To be a pilgrim, while a solemn undertaking, surely never meant a taboo on all fun and entertainment along the way. So now, after several days' hard travelling, our two latter-day pilgrims feel the need of some light relief. And what better than a summer institution with origins predating the pilgrimages of old, a village fete. This one's at Horn, just down the road from where they spent the night. There are good fates, bad fates, fates worse than death, but never a fate without a WI cake stool. As for the rest, human ingenuity knows no bounds in finding ways to part a pleasure seeker from his money. There's something about a coconut, smugly ensconced in its cup, that brings out the marksman in the male of the species. It may be the hunting instinct, it may be pure showing off. But to be on target with your first shot is a bit like running out Viv Richards.
Come along, come along. No, shoot me on there. Not quite.
Three darts for 10 pence. This is the thing to go. Here you are, sir. Don't go and throw the coconut up by mistake or that knife. Only the darts win a sticker. Yes, is it? No, not quite. Three darts for 10 pence. Is that a winner? Come along, sir. Have another go. No, not quite a winner there.
That's the one, isn't it? 10p for 3 pints.
Set them up, bartender.
Oh, that's
ten
good.
Pints.
Let me show you how to do it.
10 pints.
Come on.
Set them up, bartender. Set them up, bartender. 20.
24, gentlemen. Not quite enough.
Now that the local dancing school is on the last leg of its music and movement spectacular, it's the moment the serious punters have been waiting for, the Donkey Derby. As a reluctant entrant in the race, Toby views the whole thing with a marked lack of enthusiasm.
Mrs. Bell, can I answer Toby?
I should think so. I don't see why not.
Can you manage?
Number 7.
Number 7. We haven't got a rider, though, because I'm too fat and too big, I think.
Yeah, I suppose you are a bit. There you are. Number 7. What's she do for you?
All right. What's your name?
Pam.
Right, Pam. There he is. Toby, do you think you manage him?
Yes.
Have you ridden before?
Yes. I've got my own little horse.
Have you? So you think he's all right, do you?
Yes.
Look after him, won't you?
Yes.
Right, he's walked all the way from Winchester, so he doesn't want to run too fast. Thank you very much, then.
That's okay.
Let's go and watch the race.
Okay.
Come on, then, Job. Line them up.
What do you think of his chances?
Nil.
Come on, Job. Toby's been in position four times. Tell you what, we mustn't let him see us laugh at him.
Come on, Pam, let him go. Get him in. Good old Pam, that's him. Well done, Joe. Proud of you.
What can we draw him?
No, it's a tense moment now. It's a tense.
Go on, Joe!
There are those born with a finely tuned competitive urge, and those who would rather watch the world go by. It's doubtful if even Lester Piggott could turn Toby into championship material. It was the ultimate demonstration of how to be last by a mile and never lose your dignity. And for that dubious achievement, Toby got far more attention than the winner.
Yeah, she's got the fun. Toby's like that donkey I rode. He won't go any faster than a walk. Oh. Fame at last, Toby.
Does that mean... Look, trainer's entrance. Look through there.
What
That's
is
the
it?
Donkey trainer's entrance. Go on. Have
I don't
through.
Trust you.
The kids are waiting for you.
All right. What is it? Oh, thank you very much. Thank you, children.
They can be a bit wary, these insubstantial pageants. But any hopes of turning in early were ruined by revelers rocking the night away.
Well, it's been a really easy day, hasn't it?
It has. We haven't done very much, have we?
Nothing in the way of traveling, but I'm knackered.
Are you? What's going on in there?
It's a party. Didn't you get your invitation card?
Me? No, I never got invited. I thought you would, and I was expecting you to take me.
Didn't have me dicky, though. I wish they'd stop that music, though.
Well, so do I. I mean, we need sleep, don't we? Men of the road.
Yeah, it's all right for them. Ah, there it is. Okay, then.
That's good. The end of the party.
That's good. Now we can get some sleep. Good night to you.
And to you. Good night.
Good night.
As the new day dawns, an early start seems a good idea. Except that yesterday's all-time Donkey Derby loser has gone missing.
Did you peg him out last night?
I didn't, no. You did, didn't you?
Must have been me.
Did you? Did you check?
No, I left it to you last night. I mean, it was your turn.
What are we going to do?
Lost a donkey in my life.
Well, he's
now,
obviously...
come on, be serious. Let's
he's obviously somewhere here.
Come on, then. Toby!
Look out for the droppings. That's always a good thing.
Oh, yes, right. We'll track him down. Toby!
I'll go through here. I'll take the right.
Right, I'll go through here.
Toby! Toby!
It's ridiculous how he can disappear.
Are there yew trees around here?
Yeah, there are. Oh my god, you know any of the other poisonous bushes? I don't know, but look, just keep looking, because I want it put on record that if he's missing officially, it's your fault this time, not mine. Well, I've had enough of getting the blame all the way through this trip.
Tommy,
you've got a very good habit of putting the blame on me.
Well, this is serious. This is
there's no sign at all, is there?
Now, look, Dennis, one of us has to face the open country.
Yeah.
The other one has to face the lady of the house in case he's in the garden.
Cheers. Well, I'm not going over there, I'll tell you. Right.
Toby!
As it transpires, the wandering boy hasn't wandered very far, which is just as well, as he's taken half the washing with him.
Toby!
Lovely part of the world, that, isn't it?
It's quite nice here, isn't it? I mean, I didn't realise it could be so nice. I thought it was all busy around here, you know.
I've never been through Surrey except on motorways and railways and things.
Well, it's a good job, isn't it, for us? Because, you see, everybody going on motorways means that these little roads... Well, you know that better than I do, surely.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, when you're on the road, you've just got to select the small lanes, you know, but I just didn't expect it to be as quiet as this here.
Well, all around us, I mean, you've got Crawley, you've got Red Hill. It's all happening all around us. And people going to Gatwick Airport.
Gatwick?
I mean, yeah, they're all sweating, trying to catch their aeroplanes and doing all that sort of thing.
We could go to Gatwick, couldn't we? Get the horse on. Here's a pub.
Ah, now, do we stop?
Take a vote on it.
Well, I mean, I know you would, but you see, if you stop, you never get going again. And we have got a schedule, I think, haven't we?
All right. Reluctantly on, eh?
Because you're always talking to people. What do people talk to you about when you go in a pub? They never look at me. I mean, it's you they go for with that lovely beard.
In a pub, somebody always wants to buy the caravan. Always. Especially gypsies. How much do you want for a mush? How much will it take? Come on, I'll have it off you. How much mush?
Like that, all the time. And do they offer you a price? Because I'm dying to know how much it's worth.
No, they never offer you a price. Oh, no, that comes later. No, they'll take the caravan and negotiate the price from the campsite. No, you never offer the price. They just say, I'll take it off your mush.
You wouldn't sell, though, would you?
Oh, no, it's a family heirloom. Anyway, I've got to be buried in it. The gypsy is burnt in his vado, you know.
Well, when you get buried in that, remind me, because I want to be there to do a piece for Radio 4.
You can light the mush.
Go around this way.
Right. Do you want to get off and direct traffic then? As you're a bit... Ah, yes, the Williams Amusements. They're a bit fast around here, aren't they? Whoa, boy.
Okay,
good. Okay. See me around, Dennis, will you, please?
Yeah. Go around there, then. Okay. Get round there, then. Come on, Toby. Come on, Toby. There's a good lad. Come on, Toby.
Come on, boy.
Come on, let's chub on.
Come on, keep up. Don't go too fast.
If he's not too hot, please do.
Yes, he will. He's ready for a drink.
Hello.
We admired your vehicle. We saw you coming down the road. We've got carriages. If you'd like to see them, you're most welcome to come in.
That's very nice. Thank you.
If you have the time.
Yes. Oh, lovely. Thanks. Don't let him ask too many questions. He's a very curious man, Matt. Just let him look.
I'm sure he won't. Well, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
It may be unkind to say so, but after the dash and style of carriage driving, Marcus seems definitely one of the proletariat. But he gets there in the end, and crossing the county boundary from Surrey into Kent is a deafening reminder of how quiet, unpolluting, and sociable transportation by Marcus is. This is Cheveney, one of the few places where the old Pilgrim's Way has been diverted. It used to run through the park of Cheveney House, seat of the Stanhope family. But in 1792, the third Earl, who didn't like the hoi polloi spoiling the view, built an alternative route at his own expense. At the top of the cross stands St. Botolph, often the patron saint of churches used by travellers. When Cheveney Church was built in the 1200s, it was ideal for pilgrims catching up on their devotions because of its closeness to where the London Road crossed the Pilgrim's Way.
Evening school.
Oh yes.
Which is just down the road.
Yes.
About a mile down the road.
The walking shoes.
How do you like?
Don't often have walking shoes, but he's got them on.
Yeah, he's got to walk a little bit.
He walks and walks and.
Funny thing is that if Toby gets lost, then Marcus the horse won't go on. He stands there whinnying, looking for Toby, and once he sees Toby, that's all right.
Interestingly, the name Cheveney means dwellers on a ridge, and the first people who lived here were up on the ridge years before Christ.
Yes,
and that was their original travel route, of course.
Yes.
And then eventually they settled down here and then down in the valley.
Well, that's interesting. And did the Pilgrim's Way sort of take their old drove road?
Well, at the very top was the road,
yeah,
and then it settled at the bottom, and it was the drove road, I suppose.
Yes.
And then it came through the park and was shut out by the third Earl, who built a road south of here.
Excuse me, Jim, what's this for?
Well, that's a roller. It rolls along the ground, see, and it's on a long chain, and you put it behind the wheel, it reaches behind the wheel. So when you're going up a hill, if the horse wants to rest, it can go back and the wheels will then rest on the roller. So that's what the roller's for. Very important piece of equipment, rather like a brake.
Did the wheels always have tires on, or did they used to be wooden?
That's a very good question, because they were nearly always were made of wood, but instead of tyres, they had some steel around the edge. If you look at an old, very old cart, you'll see they've got steel edges, and that's so that they would wear. But on these modern roads, which are very difficult and,
yes,
and very smooth, then tyres are much better, much better.
What's this used for?
What's that used for? Anybody got any ideas what it might be used for? Keeping your dirty washing in, perhaps? It's got a door in there. Perhaps you could keep naughty children in there, no? Have you got an idea?
Keeping animals in.
Animals, cows, I see. Good idea. No, it's for keeping chickens in there. That's what they say it was for.
It's a bit cramped.
Bit cramped. It is a bit cramped, I agree. What, you don't approve then?
No.
No? You wouldn't like to see chickens in there?
No. How many could you fit in there?
Pardon? How many?
How many?
Oh, I don't know. One, two, three, four, perhaps? Squeezed in. Little one, little bantams. Other. But, I mean, you have to keep them somewhere, otherwise you'd lose them on the road if you were travelling, wouldn't you? But that's the reason we haven't got any in there, because we don't really think it's very nice either. We think it might be a bit cruel.
What type of caravan is it?
Well, this one is what's called a bow top, for the simple reason that it's bowed. The gypsies would call it a vardo, V-A-R-D-O, and or a wagon. Funnily enough, they never called it a caravan. And the other types there are the sort of big heavy ones like little houses. They are called redding and a cottage type. And but this one is called the canvas or the bow top.
The line of the Pilgrim's Way must have been at the bottom of that hill, perhaps going through those trees, and out into the far, far distance, and right, right across, over there to Rootham. And if we just move our eyes back again, and we go to the very top of our own building here, that must have been a point of communication when braziers were lit across the valley to tell of important events. And a turret tower is a speciality in Kent. You can often tell where you are by seeing such a turret. We are in Kent. And then looking back gradually, going round, if you look into the continuance of the valley, you're looking out towards Seal and Otford and then Kemsing. And just beneath us is our early part of the church, which in the Pilgrim's day would have had a thatched roof. If you want to think about travellers, come across this side. Looking south from here, we see the route of the pack horse route coming up from Rye to London, having come through Chipstead market area to the south of us. It then went past the 17th, 18th, 19th century cottages, past the church tower, and up through the grounds of Chevening into that far distant point, having gone up through the wheat fields. And beneath us, the site of the old rectory, where we're told in 1796, Jane Austen came on a visit and then included the site of the rectory and other parts round here in her book, Pride and Prejudice.
And so our travellers press on towards their final destination of Canterbury. Time is running short if they're to reach tonight's destination, so refreshments have to be served on the hoof.
There's a cattle grid up there.
All right,
so we'll have to go across the field, OK? Oh, it's grand going across the field. So what'll it be then?
A cup of tea would be nice.
Definitely?
Yes, please.
OK. Well, the kettle's going. That's good.
Good lad.
Oh, that shouldn't be any trouble. Cup of tea. Let's have a look.
Get the things out.
Yeah, right. Cups.
Above there, yeah, above the table, in the glass cupboard.
Right, cups there.
Yeah.
Can you take it a bit steady, Pete?
We are steady, we're all right.
Yeah, where's the tea?
Tea above the fire. Above the fire.
Above the fire. Right. Sorry, Peter.
That's good, you're all right.
He doesn't seem to be here, actually.
Is it not?
Hang on, if you want your tea, you're going to have to...
Come on.
Oh, where's the milk?
I thought you had sea legs. You were a sailor.
Where's the milk?
Milk, there are plenty of cows outside. Failing that, in this cupboard here.
This one?
Yes, that's the one.
What, one where the cups were?
No. The one behind you, the drop cupboard.
Oh, yes, I know where that is.
Right. My God, you're making a meal of this.
Do you want it in a jug?
Oh, yes, please. Let's have a touch of class. Oh, by God, is that the jug gone?
I'm sorry, Pete.
Oh, that was my favourite jug. Cottage industry.
You want a biscuit?
Oh. Thank you.
Right, now then, we're nearly ready.
Good lad.
I don't feel like a cup of tea. Do you still feel like one? Right, OK. That's it, then. We're all set to go.
Have you got the sugar?
No. Where's the sugar?
It's usually by the
cornflakes. I know where it is. It's down here by the cornflakes.
Will you shut this door, Dennis, please?
Yeah, I found the sugar.
Good
here on. It is. Good. Okay, we're all set then.
Good. Get the teapot.
Teapot right out.
The teapot's under the bed for safety.
Yeah, okay.
Now be very careful with it, Dennis. That's the travelling people's teapot. Very valuable.
I've got it.
Good lad. Good lad.
Oh, you should have it soon then.
Hey?
You should be ready for your cup of tea, sir.
Yeah, that's a special Measham teapot, that one.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
The family's had it for years. We had it on the canal, now we've had it in the van. It's wonderful. Very fond of it. Oh.
Peter?
Yeah?
How about instant coffee?